Hello students, we are back here to study square and square roots. In the previous session, we were studying exercise 6.1 and two questions we have seen. We have solved them. Now, we shall proceed to the third question. What the third question says? The question says that the squares of which of the following would be odd numbers. Understand the question carefully. The squares of which of the following would be odd numbers means after calculating the squares of these numbers, means if we calculate the square of 431, whether it would be an odd number or it would be an even number. Very simple thing to understand from this. Now, whether a number is odd or whether a number is even, forget sometime squares and all. We shall first understand whether a number is odd or even, how we decide it or how we understand it. 431, the digit in ones place or the digit in units place is 1. So, if the digit in units place is an odd digit, is odd, then number is termed as odd. Take the second number here, 2826. The digit in units place is even, so the number is even. I hope you are understanding it. Let us take the third value here, 7779. The digit in units place is 9. 9 is an odd value. So, 7779 is an odd number. Similarly, the fourth value, 82004. The digit in units place is 4, which is even. Hence, the value is even. Now, what the question says? Let us come to the question. The squares of which of the following would be odd numbers? Now, how we can understand? If in the square, in the units place, whatever digit is present, if it is odd, the square is odd. Else, if it is even, what? The square is even. Okay. Same thing means whatever we had done previously for question 1, the same we are doing here. What we are doing? 1 square is what? 1. Where it is coming? In the square of 431. In the square of 431, where 1 is coming? 1 is coming in units place. Then odd number, the square is odd number. What about 2826? 6 square, what we are getting? 36 means what will come in units place? 6 will come. Where? In the square of 2826, what is the digit in units place? It is 6, which is even. Hence, the square is even. 9 nines are 81. What we are getting? We are getting 1. Where? In units place of 7779 square. In that square, we are getting 1 in units place. So, it is an odd number. The square is an odd number. 82004. 4 square, 16. What will come in units place? 6. It is an even value. So, the square is an even number. Now, what we had to find out here, the squares of which of the following would be odd numbers? 431 square is an odd number. 7779 square is an odd number. remaining two are even numbers. I hope you have understood this. Let us proceed to the next question. What the next question says? The next question: observe the following pattern and find the missing digits. What it is? Observe the following pattern and find the missing digits. Let us see what exactly the pattern is. 11 square, 11 square is 121. 121. Pay attention. Observe carefully. 11 square is 121. That is, 11 square is 121. 101 square, 101 square. 10201. What it is? 10201. I'll not spell the number, I'll just spell the digits so that we can understand the pattern properly. Okay. So 11 square, 121. 101 square, 10201. Okay. Next, 1001 square. In the first value, no zero was present. In the second value, 10 is present. In the third value, 20s are present. Let us see what is the pattern. 2 times 0, 2. Again 2 times 0, 1. What has happened on the right hand side? 121, 10 present. So 10201 means before 2, 10 is present, after 2, 10 is present. Now here in the third row, 2 zeros are present between 1, between these 2 1, 2 zeros are present. So 2 zeros are present before 2, 2 zeros are present after 2. Understood, I hope. How many zeros are present here? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many zeros were present here? 2. How many zeros were present here? Only 1. When 10 was present, before 2, 10 we gave, after 2, 10 we gave. When 2 zeros were present, before 2 we gave 2 zeros and after 2 we gave 2 zeros. Now 4 zeros are present. Simple thing, looking to the above pattern, 4 zeros before 2 and 4 zeros after 2 and here 1. 1 was already present here. I'll write it once again. It is written a little bit crooked. I'll try to write in between there. 4 zeros are given in between the 2 ones. So 4 zeros are present before 2 and 4 zeros are present after 2. Is the pattern continued? Now let us see here. How many zeros between 2 ones? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 zeros are present here. So what we are doing? 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. After that, 2 is present. Again, 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And lastly, 1 is present. You can check here, 10 is present. So 10 before 2, 10 after 2. 2 zeros before 2, 2 zeros after 2. 4 zeros, so we have given 4 zeros before 2, 4 zeros after 2. On the basis of this pattern, whatever has been explained to us, on the same way, on the same pattern we have studied, we have done it. So how many zeros here? 2, 4, 6 zeros. So first 1 is present as it is. 6 zeros after 1, 2, 4, 6. 2 after 2, 6 zeros and then 1. I hope you have understood this. Let us proceed further for the next question. What's the next question? Observe the following pattern and supply the missing numbers. Okay. What they are saying? Again, one more pattern they have given, and they are saying supply the missing numbers. Here you can see the above pattern. We can see 1 1 square 1 0 1 square, okay, 1 0 0 1 square, in this way. Now let us come to question 5 and let us observe this pattern. 1 1 square 1 2 1, it is just similar to this thing on the top. Whatever is present, we can compare it. 1 0 1 square 1 0 2 0 1, okay. Third value, here it was 1 0 0 1 square. Now here it is not 1 0 0, it is 1 0 1 0 1 square. Here the difference is starting. What is the value here? 1 0 1 0 1 square. We are studying the pattern, not the whole numbers. So 1 0 1 0 1 square is what? 1 0 2 0 3 0 2 0 1. We were knowing in this pattern that whatever the number of zeros are present between the two ones, that many number of zeros were present before 2 and after 2 in this pattern. Now here what is happening? 1 0 1 0 1 square is what? 1 0 2 0 3 0 2 0 1. Means what? Whatever the number of 1 are present, please understand carefully what I am saying. Whatever the number of 1 are present, that many natural numbers we are going to write. How many 1 are present here? 3 1s are present here. So 1, 2, 3. After that it is decreasing, 2, 1. Now what about the zeros? 2 zeros. So 2 zeros before these natural numbers, whatever we are writing. And again, same thing in decreasing order. I hope you are understanding. Now 1 0 1 0 1 0 1, how many 1s are present? 1 2 3 4 4. So we shall try to solve this. 1 0 2 0 3 0 4 0 3 0 2 0 1. Please cross check with the previous pattern. 1 0 1 0 1 square. So 1 0 2 0 3 0 2 0 1. What we had done? 3 ones are present, 3 natural numbers we are taking, 2 zeros are present. So till the maximum natural number we are inserting 1 1 0. After that again 1 1 0, means 2 times zeros are present before the highest natural number, between them, instead of saying between them, and again the same thing, decreasing. See here, 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 square. How many times 1 is present? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times 1 is present. How many zeros are present? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. In between, zeros are present. How many zeros? 1, 2, 3. After the maximum, it starts decreasing. 0, 3, 0, 2, 0, 1. Now, in the next one, they are asking us to write the number whose square is 1 0 2 0 3 0 4 0 5 0. After that 4 0 3 0 2 0 1. It is decreasing. how many till what the maximum natural number has gone? Till 5. Here how many ones were present? 4 ones. So what it went till? 4 it went. Now it has gone till 5. So what we have to do here? We have to write here 1 0 1 0 1 0. This happened how much? 3 times 1 is present. 1 0. 4 times 1 is present, and this is 1 square. Square is already present here. You can see in the textbook already square is present there. So what is happening? How many times 1 is present? 1 2 3 4 5. Here you can see in the front 1 2 3 4 5. How many zeros are present here? 1 2 3 4. 1 2 3 4. It is decreasing. Again 4 zeros afterwards, and 4 3 2 1 in between them. It is in decreasing order. The natural numbers are decreasing. You can see the pattern. You can understand the pattern properly. Let us proceed further. Before proceeding, just study the first pattern properly. On the same basis, a little bit of changes are there. You can understand the second pattern. Now let us go to the next question. Let us see what is the pattern in the next question. I hope you people are understanding it properly. What is the sixth question? Using the given pattern, find the missing numbers. What they are saying? Using the given pattern, find the missing numbers. Before that, there is a box here. It is explaining something. To find pattern, third number is related to first and second number. How? We have to study it. Fourth number is related to third. How? We have to study that. They have given a hint to us. What hint they have given? That third number is related to first and second number. How we have to find out? And fourth number is related to third number. How we have to find out? Now let us study the pattern. 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square is equal to 3 square. Okay, what is the answer here? 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square is equals to 3 square. Okay. 2 square plus 3 square plus 6 square is equals to 7 square. 3 square plus 4 square plus 12 square is equals to 13 square. Okay. Till here the pattern is given. After that, something is missing that we have to fill it. But before filling it, we shall understand what this pattern means. Here the hint is given. Third number is related to first and second number. Let us study the third number. 2 is present here, 6 is present here, 12 is present here. How we can get 2 here with relation with 1 and 2? Because here it is explained to us, it is related to first and second number. So here the first number is 1 and the second number is 2. That squares are taken, but before that let us see only of that number. So what makes 2 to come again with the relation between 1 and 2? It is only multiplication. Why? Because 1 2's are 2. If I take 1 plus 2, it becomes 3. If I take 1 minus 2 or 2 minus 1, it becomes 1. So what relation we can have here? Understand carefully. It is 1 multiplied by 2 is 2. 2 multiplied by 3 is 6. 3 multiplied by 4 is 12. I hope the third number is related. How it is related? Not related. How it is related to first and second number, we have understood. Now it is clear. What it is? Multiplying the first number with the second number, we get the third number. 1, 2's are 2. 2, 3's are 6. 3, 4's are 12. Okay. Now, fourth number is related to third number. How? Yes, we have to find out that. This is the fourth number. 2 is the third number and 3 is the fourth number. Now, how can we have a correlation in between both of them? What should be done to 2 so that I can get 3? I cannot multiply 2 into 1 to get 3. No, not possible. I cannot subtract from 2 1 so that I can get 3. Not possible. If I add 1 to 2, if I add 1 in 2, I will get 3. So, 2 plus 1, 3. 6 plus 1, 7. 12 plus 1, 13. I think we have understood this particular thing. Third number, how it is coming, and fourth number, how it is coming. Now we shall see the missing numbers. What happened here? 1 2s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 3 4s are 12, 4 5s are 20. 4 5s are 20. This is square. Just a minute, I will just write a small, because this square is getting, I will write little bit small here, 20. 4 into 5, 20, 20 plus 1, 21. So, we understood the relation between the third number as well as the relation between the fourth number. Now, let us come to the next pattern here, that we have to write the missing number. This is what multiplication of first and second number. So, 5 how many is 30? It is 5 6 is 30. It is 5 6 is 30. 30 plus 1 31. Okay. Now, let us come here. Here 2 of the numbers are missing. First we shall find the third number. 6 7 is 42. 6 7 is 42. And what about here? 42 plus 1, 43. 42 plus 1 is 43. Now, what it is? 4 square plus 5 square plus 20 square is equals to 21 square. And here we can see now, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 2 square is 4, 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9, which is what? 3 square, that is 9. Similarly, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 6 square is 36. Add all of them, you will get 49, which is nothing but 7 square. On the same basis, 4 square plus 5 square plus 20 square, it will become 21 square. 5 square plus 6 square plus 30 square is equal to 31 square. 6 square plus 7 square plus 42 square is equal to 43 square. The pattern was explained to us. On that basis, we have filled the missing numbers. I hope the concept is clear, you have understood, and you will be able to solve on your own. Proceeding further to the next question. What is the next question? Question 7. Without adding, find the sum. What is the question? Without adding, find the sum. Now, for this, we shall go to our previous pages where this concept is explained to us. Without adding, find the sum. Adding odd numbers. 1, 1 odd number is equals to 1 square. Sum of first 2 odd numbers is equals to 2 square. Sum of first 3 odd numbers is equals to 3 square. Sum of first 4 odd numbers, 4 square. Sum of first 5 odd numbers, 5 square. Sum of first 6 odd numbers, 6 square. What they are concluding? Sum of first n odd natural numbers is n square. Sum of first n odd natural numbers is n square. If the number is a square, it has to be the sum of successive odd numbers starting from 1. Okay, not required in this reference for the exercise that we are doing. Okay, so back to our question. Odd numbers. How many odd numbers are there? First, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is equals to what? 5 square is equals to 25. Just now only we have seen sum of first 5 odd numbers is 5 square is 25. Similarly, how many first odd numbers are present here? We have to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many odd numbers? 10. So, it is what? 10 square. 10 square is 100. Without adding, find the sum. I have not added anything. Only I have counted that how many odd numbers are there from the starting. Proceeding further, for the next sum, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. What it is? The sum of first 12 odd numbers is what? 12 square. So, what is the answer? 144. I hope you have understood this. Let us proceed to next question, that is 8th question. What is the 8th question? In that there are two sub questions. The first one is express 49 as the sum of 7 odd numbers. Express 49 as the sum of 7 odd numbers. Very simple thing. Whatever we have done just now, that was this part. Whatever I had written, that was this part. What is 49? 49 is 7 square. So, write the first 7 odd numbers sum, you will get 49. What are the 7 odd numbers from first? 1. From the starting, the 7 odd numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. How many it happened? 5. 6th odd number and 7th odd number. Express 49 as the sum of 7 odd numbers means what? I can write here 49 is equals to 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13. Count, they are 7 odd numbers. Okay, they are 7 odd numbers. What is the next sum? The next sum is express 121. Oh, I should have not rubbed it. It would have become very easy for us just by making a few changes in this. Okay, let it be. I'll solve it one second. I'll write it one second. Not a problem. Express 121 as the sum of 11 odd numbers. So, I can write like this. 121, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13. These became 7, 13, 15, 17. How many these became? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Still two more we require. 17, 19 and 21. So, the sum of first 11 odd numbers is 11 square and that is what? 121. Or we can solve in another way. But as this session is getting concluded here, in the next session, I will show you one more method of solving this. This has been explained to us in our content previously. We shall refer to that content and then we shall solve this sum by other method. Okay, this method is also correct, or the alternative method will also be correct. Till that time, you people take care of yourselves and study properly and regularly. Thank you.